Love your angry neighbor. Love your sinful neighbor. Love your gay neighbor. Love your Muslim neighbor. Hi there fam, welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad to be here filming. Another video, and you already know the drill. Subscribe if you have not, because we have to reach that monthly target. We have to eat it, and the target for this month is 500 subscribers and 1500 views. So please help me eat my monthly target, and God bless you as you do so. So I think I'm too close to the screen. Okay, this is nice. What do I want to say? Let's go into today's video. Habit number one is being judgmental. And what do I have to say about being judgmental? Matthew 7:1-5. Matthew 7:1-5. The answer to that is in Matthew 7:1-5. It's not nice that Christians, believers, are judgmental. And I'm not condemning anyone. I'll just say the solution to this is that instead of being judgmental, learn to mind your business and put yourself in the shoes of the person you are judging, and always ask yourself WWJD. Number two is saying I'll pray for you when they really know they won't. And it's not nice actually, but like I said earlier, I'm not judging anyone. And the solution to this is that whenever you say I will pray for you, try to do it immediately. Try to start praying, even if it's inside and it's not audible. Just make sure you are doing it with intentionality and you are very, very genuine, so you don't end up forgetting and you don't have a debt on your head to pay. Number three is complaining about your church service. And what I have to say about that is, if the service does not impress you, instead of complaining and nagging, try to look for a way to help the service become better. What are they not doing right? What are they doing wrong? Help them realize these mistakes and help the service become better. Find a solution to the problem and stop nagging. Be a solution giver, not a problem finder. Number four is excluding non-Christians. And what I have to say about this is, love your neighbor, love your angry neighbor, love your sinful neighbor, love your gay neighbor, love your Muslim neighbor, love your lukewarm neighbor, love your non-believer neighbor, and maybe your love will show them what Jesus is really all about. Love your neighbor. It is not yours to judge. It is not yours to condemn. So love your neighbor. Maybe your love will show them the light and let them realize what Jesus really is all about. Number five is gossiping by sharing a prayer request. You know when you say, oh, let's pray for Sister Lagbaja, and then you now start gossiping about the person. God is watching you. Check Proverbs 20:19 and Ephesians 4:29. Those of you on that table, check those two Bible verses I call that now. And what do I have to say to this? Either you keep quiet or you pray genuinely without sharing secrets. Either you keep quiet and you don't pray at all, or you just pray with intentionality, be genuine about your prayers, than sharing someone's secrets all in the name of let us pray for. It's not nice. And number six is being hypocritical. And this point is not just with mere mortals, it's not just with men, but also with God. Many talk about God's love. Oh, I love Jesus, I'm in love. Oh, with Jesus, I'm in love. We always saying we love God, and we are actually not showing that love. What I mean is, you are saying you love Jesus, but you're not showing that love you have for Jesus to your neighbors. You're not even showing the love to God himself. So how then do we believe that you really love him? Stop being hypocritical. Oh, Jesus, I love you, and then you're now doing something that says the opposite of God's love. Start preaching what you practice. Start walking the talk. Be a person of integrity. The next point here is calling God's name in vain. And a lot of us are on this table, even me, I'm still working on myself, but I think I'm now better than where I used to be. And it's not nice, because Exodus 20:7 tells us to not call the name of God in vain. And If you cannot call your parents' name anyhow, like you just start calling them, oh, Grace, oh, David, oh, Mary, oh, Anna. You can't call your parents' name anyhow. Then how much more God? Like, how much more God? Be more disciplined and have some respect for God. Stop calling his name anyhow. Stop taking him for granted. And the final point here is putting other things before God. Matthew 6:33 says that seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto you. I'm not judging anyone, because sometimes I find myself in this place as well. I find myself, and a good example is this. Most of us don't even know it's wrong. When someone is sick, and then the next thing you tell the person is, what have you used? Or, oh, take drugs. Instead of you to pray for the person and exercise your authority as a child of God, you start recommending drugs, or have you used drugs? Pray first. And then after the prayers, you now say, oh, have you used anything? Use this, do that. Not the other way around. God first. And the solution to this is be intentional and make quality time for God. Trust him wholeheartedly and be committed to your relationship with him. That way, you always remember to put him first, to put him at the center of everything. And I really tried to make this video as short as possible. Don't forget to subscribe, to like, to share, and interact with me in the comment section. Hope to see you guys in my next video. Hope to see you guys really, really soon. Stay tuned. God bless you.
Bye.